On today's Fast Friday, I'm going to compare low light ISO performance on the XT3 versus the XT4. Roll that intro. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. When the XT4 was released, it introduced a number of new features, most notably in-body image stabilization and a much better battery life. However, Fujifilm decided to use the same X-Trans sensor in the XT4 that was in the XT3. ISO performance in low light depends on a lot more than just the camera sensor. ISO can be a complicated but fascinating topic. I have a whole series of videos on ISO, and in fact, I just created a brand new ISO playlist. Be sure to check that out after this video. I decided to test for myself high ISO on both the XT3 and the XT4. Now, this is supposed to be just a fun test. It's not a full-blown, laboratory here, but I did want to see for myself just, how these cameras handle higher ISO values in low light. For my test, I used the exact same settings on each camera. I used the exact same lens as well, the 18-55 zoom for some of my photos, and the 23mm f2 prime for others. And then I imported these raw files in both Lightroom and Capture One. For both programs, I made sure to disable any automatic noise reduction, sharpening, or any other processing to make sure that everything was set to zero. So here's what I discovered. The XT3 is on the left and the XT4 is on the right. Zooming in at 100%, it's very difficult to see the difference. They look almost identical. However, when I look at the color chart, I can see a little bit more noise on the XT3 side, just right here. You see that? Compared to right here. If I zoom into 200, it is definitely more noticeable. There is more noise here. If I look at the chair in the background right here, you can see there is more noise generally in the darker areas. And even in the lighter areas of the image, the XT4 does handle the noise better at ISO 6400. Let's have a look now at ISO 12800 in Lightroom. Zooming into 100%, I can definitely see more noise. Look at the chair cushion right here. Now, if I increase that to 200%, no question about it, there is more noise. The XT4 at ISO 12800 handles the noise better. Now, how much of this is maybe worms in Lightroom? Let's switch over to Capture One. So now I'm in Capture One. I have the XT3 on the left side of the screen and the XT4 on the right side of the screen. Zooming into the color chart at 200%, even in Capture One, there are definitely less worms, but there is more noise on the XT3. See how you can see these green splotchy areas right there. Looking at a brighter area of the image, this time I'm at 300%, and it seems like there's more color noise coming from the XT3. And I'm at 200% looking in Capture One right now at ISO 12800. The image is definitely noisier at 200%. If I back off to 100%, I can see a difference though. You might not be able to looking at this on YouTube, but I can see a slight difference. It's not huge, but it's there in Capture One. So here it is in Lightroom at 200%, and here it is in Capture One at 200%. Let's go back to 100%, but now we're looking at ISO 25600 on both cameras, and clearly the XT3 is performing worse. Look at that compared to that. Let me zoom in now to 200% on each one. And it seems to be even the most noticeable in the lighter areas. Flipping over to Capture One now, looking at ISO 25600. One thing I am seeing is in the darker areas, like right here on the XT3, there is more color noise. See that right there? Have a look at that. Look at the difference between this area and this area right here. Remember though, I'm at ISO 25600 for heaven's sake. Lastly, here's ISO 51200 in Lightroom. Let's have a look. Zoomed into 200%, no question about it, the XT4 is better. You see that? I then decided to test high ISO with video, With both cameras, I shot 4K F-log footage at 24 frames a second using the highest available codec all-intra at H.265 with HDMI out at 422 10-bit, recording straight into the Atomos Ninja 5 monitor. Here's the F-log footage straight out of camera at ISO 6400. Here it is at ISO 12800. But look at how there is a difference between the XT3 and the XT4. Overall, what I found from this fun test is that once you start to crank up the ISO, the noise definitely gets more pronounced in both the XT3 and the XT4. I do think that the XT4 does have better low light performance, especially with stills, in the ISO 6400 to 10,000 range. And I found that even more pronounced in Lightroom than I did Capture One, but that could be due to the demosaicing of the raw file done by Lightroom. But Capture One, even at 100%, I could see the difference. For most people, no, you're not gonna be shooting at these incredibly high ISO ranges. But for me, it was interesting to see the difference because these cameras have exactly the same X-Trans sensor. So obviously there's something improved or changed or modified in the circuitry of the XT4. I hope this video has been helpful or at least fun. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to give it the like and subscribe. Next week, I expect to have not one, but two different product reviews for you. And don't forget to have a wonderful weekend. Get out there and try and find some time to explore your creativity. And I'll see you in another video next week. Take care.